the adversaries may occur in real world. Therefore, the understanding of the trend of the microplastic pollution is very much important. To see such trend, we apply our methodology to reconstruct pollution history by using sediment core. So sediment core records the history of pollution. So we are, this methodology is very much traditional methodology in the field of geochemistry or in the field of the pollution sciences. So we apply this methodology to some of the Asian and African countries to collect sediment core from the inland lakes and also the coastal zone. We have the result collected from, obtained from Tokyo. The y-axis means the depth in core. So deeper means the past, and shallower means present. And we made dating of this core by using the some kind of anthropogenic compounds as a marker. And also we measured the radionuclides as a time marker. And this most bottom layer corresponds to 1800s. At that time we had no plastic production. Therefore we observed no plastic. This is very much visible. And in 1950s, we did observe small amounts of plastic, microplastic, in the middle layer of sediment core. At this time, we Japan started to produce the microplastics. Therefore, we found some. And after that, our plastic production increased dramatically. Corresponding to that, we found large amounts, large numbers of plastic in the marine surface water in the mid-2000s. This means plastic pollution is increasing, getting serious. And similar increasing trend from the deeper part to the shallower part of sediment core were observed in some other sediment cores collected from Thailand, Malaysia, and South Africa. Unfortunately, we don't have sediment core in India, so in future, we hope to collect sediment core to take sediment core to demonstrate the historic trend of the microplastic pollution. Hopefully, in future, you may see decreasing trend due to some of the countermeasure and solution. But unfortunately, the American scientists predicted the future increasing trend in microplastic and plastic input to pollution. American scientists jumped, estimated the amounts of accumulated amounts of plastic to the sea would be increased by a factor of 10 in coming 20 years if we will not take any action. Therefore, we have to take any action to reduce the plastic pollution in the environment, especially in this area of the tropical Asia, in the large source or big source area of plastic waste into the ocean. But unfortunately, we have very much limited information about the pollution of microplastics and associated chemicals in this area. So we have to study more in tropical Asian countries. And based on this situation, many international agencies, especially United Nations, are interested in or concerned about the plastic pollution. And they have many meetings during the last 5 years. One of the big meetings which I attended was the Ocean Conference, which was held in New York, the headquarters of the United Nations, in this June. And this conference is not specialized to the microplastics, but this conference is to facilitate the United Nations SDG, that is the Sustainable Development Goals.